The term rocket science is often used to describe a concept that is quite difficult to understand. But in this video, we are going to explain the technology behind rockets and rocket engines in a simplified, scientific manner. To keep the rocket moving, you have to eject from it a huge amount of mass at high speed. This is simply Newton's third law of motion. The greater the momentum the rocket loses, the more force or thrust on the rocket. To eject the high-speed mass from the rocket, a liquid fuel oxidizer mixture is burnt in the rocket combustion chamber. The combustion chamber also helps the fuel and oxidizer to mix in an efficient manner due to its clever mixing design. The high-speed jet is passed through a specially shaped rocket nozzle. The function of the nozzle is to increase the exhaust velocity even further, thus increasing the rocket's thrust. These kinds of nozzles are called converging-diverging nozzles. The subsonic flow is converted to a supersonic flow with the help of such a nozzle. The liquid fuel, before entering the combustion chamber, travels entirely around the nozzle body. This helps to reduce the nozzle cover temperature and also results in some energy savings. To pump the fuel and oxidizer at an adequate flow rate, two pumps are used. These pumps are driven by a turbine, which is connected to the same shaft as the pumps. The pump turbine unit is referred to as a turbopump. A gas generator produces hot gas, which will turn the turbine. A bypassed stream of fuel and an oxidizer are fed into the gas generator for the purpose of combustion. Exhaust from the turbine is mixed with the main rocket exhaust. This unit of the rocket is called the rocket engine. The rocket engine we have discussed so far is more specifically called a liquid propellant rocket engine. They are the most powerful and versatile rocket propulsion systems available. The fuel and oxidizer required for the rocket engine are stored in two large tanks, as shown. During liftoff, the thrust produced by the main engine may not be sufficient. So usually, a few solid propellant strap boosters are used to assist the liftoff. You can see more details about solid propellant rockets here. The rocket starts with zero speed at the ground, but it should accelerate to a final speed of around 28,000 kilometers per hour to successfully achieve orbit. The solid propellant strap boosters are burned off very rapidly. So to reduce the weight of the rocket, they are abandoned after the burn-off. This process is known as rocket staging. When the main engine is burned off, it is also abandoned and the next engine takes over the charge. In this way, the rocket's weight is greatly reduced, thus greater acceleration can be achieved. Finally, after a few stages of operation, the payload is put into the desired orbit. Rocket staging up to 5 has been successfully tested. You might be wondering how the rocket is able to maneuver itself to reach its destination. The most modern and common technique is called gimbaled thrust. Here, the rocket nozzle is tilted by high-precision devices. It is clear that any deviation from its normal angle will produce torque, which will make the rocket's body turn. After achieving enough turn, the gimbal angle is set to zero. You can see more details of the gimbal mechanism here. We hope you got a nice introduction on the working of rockets and rocket engines. Thank you for watching the video.